Well, here we are, Isabella, in Odense Concert Hall for this semi-final. And you know Odense very well.
I do. I actually studied my first years here in Odense at the Nielsen Academy of Music. And I've been back and played with the orchestra a few times. And it's just a nice city, and I love to be back. It feels at home, almost.
Playing as a flautist, we should say, you are our expert this evening.
I try to be, definitely. And I mean, I think it's such a great thing right now. The whole city is like busting with young musicians. I mean, where do you see three competitions at one time? You have the violin competition, the clarinet competition, and the flute competition in the same week. Yeah. So the whole city is just filled with young rising stars, and I think you can feel that energy. That's really interesting.
Certainly, it becomes almost like a mini festival when you have more than 60 budding soloists knocking around one place.
Very much. I think it's definitely in the spirit of Carl Nielsen, I would say. So I think that's a great idea to do it like that.
And this orchestra has Carl Nielsen in its blood, of course. The orchestra of Nielsen's hometown. Do you feel that when you've played with them, that Nielsen is their sort of house composer?
I think when the orchestra and the musicians play Nielsen here in Odense, it feels like coming home, because you know the nature, you know the village where he comes from, and the weather, not to mention that as well. I mean, the whole Danishness, so to speak, that's in his music and somehow in our blood. So I think it just feels like coming home when we play Nielsen here in Denmark.
And of course, things have changed rather since this competition became one that's held three at a time. It used to be separated out, didn't it, before 2019. And worth saying that Nikolai Zepp-Schneider has very much been behind that, the rebirth of the competition, and is very keen to ensure that all the competitors benefit not just from their progress through the competition, but from the experience they have in all of the rounds, even the first round. And it's very interesting to see. He said the competition is not just about the winner, and the Nielsen competition must represent the full circle of life, the full circle of life for musicians. I'm quoting here from Nikolai Zepp-Schneider. I mean, you're a freelance musician. You know how hard it is out there, even though you're very experienced. These young musicians, especially after a pandemic, they must be looking out into the world and wondering how they can make their way. This composition must be very useful for them.
I think so. It's definitely a door opener. Of course it is. And what I find so interesting is also this piece they have requested playing around Nielsen. That is so unusual for a competition. Usually you have maybe a piece written for the competition, but this is like where the contestants are supposed to be creative and make this collage, and that's really special.
Mm-hmm. Yes, this is the brief of to take themes by Carl Nielsen, combine them with themes from composers from the past, and then create a sort of free improvisation around that, which was in the last round, was it, or the?
It's in the second round.
In the second round,
I think, yeah. Mm-hmm. The round prior to this semi-final.
Yeah.
And I just think it's a great idea, because you get to be creative and choose all these bits of music by Carl Nielsen, and put them together in your own piece. I mean, that sounds just such a great idea.
Yeah, and yes, a real test of a musician's ability to structure a piece and to sort of tell a story, I suppose, as well.
Definitely
as being inside the style.
Definitely storytelling, yes. Mm-hmm. But now the orchestra has tuned, and it's the Odense Symphony Orchestra we have here in Odense Concerthus. And they have tuned their instruments, and they're getting ready. We are getting ready.
(Clears throat) Well, a very warm welcome to the Odense Concert Hall here on Fyn, the island in central Denmark, for this, the flute semi-final of the Carl Nielsen International Music Competition.
What a busy week it has been. We have had 22 contestants, and we are now down to the final six flute players that we are going to hear tonight. And my name is Isabella Hübner, and I'm a flutist here in Denmark. And actually, I started my career here in Odense at the Carl Nielsen Academy of Music many years ago.
So Isabella feels very at home. My name's Andrew Meller. I'm a journalist and critic based in Copenhagen. It's great to be with you. And Isabella, it's, as you said, it's been quite a week. We've heard a lot of music so far.
And now we're going to hear about the prizes.
We are going to hear about the prizes because there's a lot at stake at this competition. Let's take you through exactly what. 12,000 euros for the winner of the flute competition, 10,000 for the second-placed flautist, 7,500 for the third-placed flautist, and 1,000 euro prizes given by the Odense Symphony Orchestra, given by the children's jury that presides, as well as the adult jury, the audience, gives a 1,000 euro prize, and also the prize for the best interpretation of a work by Carl Nielsen. But to tonight's repertoire, Isabella.
Yes, we are going to hear amazing music by André Jolivet, the flute concerto, the first challenging movement. And then the contestants have had the option of choose between the G major or the D minor concerto by Carl Philipp Emanuel Bach. And the funny thing is, they all chose the D minor. I would have chosen that too. So my favorite of mine, but we're going to hear that six times today. And that's the second and third movement we're going to hear from that concerto.
Great minds think
yes.
alike. And everything changes for the contestants now. They've played on their own, they've played with a pianist, and now they have to negotiate the dynamic of a concerto, establishing a rapport with a conductor, tonight's conductor, Lena-Lisa, Wüstendorfer, but of course also establishing some sort of relationship, some sort of musical dialogue with the Odense Symphony Orchestra. It's a complete new challenge, Isabella, and the first contestant to take that challenge on tonight is Yuan Yu. He is 30 years old, and he is currently a student at the Paris Conservatoire, an experienced musician, if anyone has watched so far through the competition, a very capable and charismatic one too. And he is ready, so please welcome to the stage, 30 years old, the first contestant, Yuan Yu.
Thank you.
What a start to the semi-final, Andrew. The hall was buzzing.
Yeah.
I mean, such amazing music, and what a great musician.
Indeed, an incredible two pieces separated by 200 years and just completely different. You feel in that music by C.P.E. Bach, the dawn of a new world, kind of sort of new age trying to break through. It takes so much agility from the flautist, doesn't it? And we're used to hearing music like that played on a wooden flute. Perhaps you can explain.
On a traverso.
Yeah.
Yes, definitely. I mean, the whole challenge in the semi-final is that you start with this French piece, Jolivet, where you need to master the technique of, you know, all the highest notes and all these extended techniques, the flutter-tongue, the harmonics, the huge register jumps you need to master, and then suddenly you need to go to a completely different world and time. It's like going in the time machine back to Carl Philipp Emanuel Bach, and as you say, to the original flute playing, which was this wooden stick with no mechanic and no things for the fingers. It was like a recorder just this way.
And for the layperson, those of us who don't play wind instruments, we just look at a performance like that and wonder, how can you have enough wind in your lungs to play passages that long and that intricate?
Practice, practice, practice. I guess. But of course, there are techniques to do that. And I guess it was easier in many ways to play it on the original flute because it didn't demand the same flow of air through this wooden one instead of the one we play today, which is in metal, in all different kind of metals you can choose to play it on. But the whole thing of playing it on a modern flute today is trying to find the wooden sound or the imagine how the sound would be on a wooden flute, even though you play on a modern flute. And then the challenge was going from the Jolivet to the Carl Philipp Emanuel Bach with no intermission between. It's really challenging, definitely.
Mm-hmm. Well, Isabella, our next contestant is ready, and you can tell us a bit about her.
I can. The next contestant is Violeta de Los Angeles Gil Garcia. She is 25 years old, and she studies at the Musikhochschule Freiburg. And she is ready now for the Jolivet and the Carl Philipp Emanuel Bach D minor.
Thank you. Thank you.
Violeta de los Angeles Gil Garcia there, and another scintillating performance of that D minor concerto by C.P.E. Bach. Although I guess the slow movement is in D major, isn't it?
It is indeed. Yeah. And I mean, it's just so, so beautiful music. And I was wondering why, what they could have in common, the Jolivet and the Carl Philipp Emanuel Bach. And I was thinking that the Jolivet has this scherzando, the second part of it, of what they are playing, which has this danzante feeling and also this jazzy vibes almost. And this final movement of the D minor concerto also has, it's more like a rock and roll concerto almost, this baroque kind of feeling. It's really badass, I want to say, almost, because it's so cool and it demands so much skills of the flutist. This double tonguing that's supposed to be so fast, but still clear and crisp, and you need to hear everything in the articulation, and this fiery accompaniment of the orchestra here in Odense Symphony Orchestra. I mean, wow.
Yeah, now you're using technical terms on us now, Isabella, double tonguing.
Yes.
What is that?
Well, when composers write something that is so fast that you cannot tongue it with a single tongue, you had to invent something else, and that's a double tongue. So you use the front, and then there's a discussion of which part of the tongue you should use. But in short, it's and that's how you do it.
You make it sound so easy. And
I'm not playing the flute right now.
In the Jolivet. We could talk about a little bit about the provenance of that piece, because it's very interesting. But there is another technique in that piece that sounds sort of similar to that double tonguing you did. Am I right? Towards the end, there's a sort of flutter tongue. Is that the right
description? Yes, that is, again, when you go back to the Jolivet concerto, you have all these extended techniques that are special for that period of composing, where you start to challenge the flute and start to look what you can do different with the sound and the skills of the flutist. So you invent stuff. Mm-hmm. You do, for example, the flutter tongue, and that's like some people do it here, some people do it there. Again, it's a big discussion of what's right. But then you have the harmonics as well, which are also that's overtones on violin, on strings. That would be the flageolet, and yeah, all these kind of techniques you need to master to play this piece.
And it's very interesting, the Jolivet concerto was written for the great flautist Jean-Pierre Rampal. And am I right in saying that he played in a competition, Rampal, and there was a piece by Jolivet written for that competition. He was so taken with this piece that he then commissioned a full concerto from...
Yes, that was Jean de Linos, and then Jolivet and Jean-Pierre Rampal became great friends, and that's why he commissioned or became this Jolivet concerto for Rampal. And I think we're ready for the next contestant.
Yes, we are indeed, and it is Se-Yoon Kim, 20 years old, and very experienced young flautist. She is already the principal flute of the great Goethenic Orchestra in Cologne, a seasoned competitor. So we will welcome her back to the stage now, along with Lena-Lisa Wüstendorfer.
Thank you.
So we are halfway, Andrew, the first three contestants, and now we are having an intermission.
We are indeed, and I think the Odense Symphony Orchestra needs as much of a rest as our finalists and conductor do. The interval, the pause, will be 40 minutes, I'm being told, rather than 20 minutes while we... so we are back on at 9 o'clock. So we'll see you then for three more Jolivets and three more C.P.E. Bachs.
Welcome back here in Odense Konzerthus to the Carl Nielsen competition. We are back here and we have just heard the first three contestants at the flute competition, and now we are ready for the next three.
We are indeed. Yes, the next three semi-finalists will still be hearing Jolivet, we'll still be hearing Carl Philipp Emanuel Bach, and first we'll be hearing from Alberto Acuña Almella. He is 25 years old, a member of the Carian Academy of the Berlin Philharmonic Orchestra and a student at the École de Musique de Genève. So we welcome him and tonight's conductor, Lena-Lisa of Wüstendorf.
And Odense Symphony Orchestra.
Thank you.
Again, just wow, another amazing musician we have just listened and watched. I was wondering, it is such a mountain they climb, these contestants in this competition. There is such a huge amount of repertoire they have been forcing and experiencing since Friday, where they started with the first round. It's like climbing Mount Everest, I would presume,
yes,
actually.
And it's worth reminding ourselves that these contestants have been here since Friday and that this is a long haul, this competition, and many of them will be hoping they're still here on Saturday. Now, Isabella, as a professional musician, you have participated in competitions like this, I'm sure, as a competitor and maybe as an orchestra member. There are so many things that these contestants can think about to help them through, aren't there? There's ways of pacing yourself through a competition, of ascertaining when to sort of bear all and when to maybe hold back a little more. There's techniques like looking yourself in the mirror before you go on stage, of telling yourself you can achieve something, you can perform to the best of your abilities. How do you think these young musicians are coping with the pressure, and what techniques will they use?
I think it is a long process to prepare for this sort of performance, and preparation is definitely key, so that you have time enough to prepare, of course, the music, and but also mentally, because it is such a forceful thing to be here in the middle of everything in front of a big hall, and you at home as well, and to be able to be here and actually still perform, and not only perform but tell the story of the music, because that is what is important, to bring along the composer's ideas with the music. And it is just a long way of preparing, and there are a lot of techniques, and I'm sure that all the contestants have many and create their own as well. So it's difficult to say just one.
We can come back to that perhaps in a moment, especially the idea of memory, which we have to remember these musicians are performing from memory, and there's a lot of notes in that C.P.E. Bach
there is.
Final movement. But well, I think we can go to our next.
I think we are ready for the next contestant, our fifth contestant. That is Nikolai Song. He is 19 years old, and he studies at the Paris Conservatoire, and he's also an experienced concerto soloist. So let him be welcome together with the conductor, Lena-Lisa Wüstendorfer.
Nikolai Song there, 19 years old, a student at the Paris Conservatoire, and still more agility and focus and extraordinary virtuosity from these flautists, Isabella.
I mean, I'm almost speechless, yeah. And that doesn't happen so often. No, I mean, it's just so impressive what they can deliver at this late night hour as well, and they just keep being better than the other, than the other, than the other. It's just amazing what these flutists can do.
Yeah. Well, working even later than our flautists tonight are, of course, our jury. Let's remind you of who's on our jury in this flute part of the Carl Nielsen International Competition and the task they have in hand. So the jury is chaired by Karl-Heinz Schütz, principal flute of the Vienna Philharmonic Orchestra. Orchestras don't come much more distinguished than that. He's joined by some of the great names from the world of woodwind playing, Emily Bennion, the Royal Concertgebouw Orchestra's principal flute, distinguished flautists, including Gruner Must, the Odense Symphony Orchestra's principal flute, orchestra chiefs from Oslo and Stockholm, Marina Piccinini, a great flute virtuoso, and a bassoonist, Gilbert Audin from France, a distinguished bassoonist. Isabella, they have a task in hand, don't they? They don't just sit around enjoying the music and then have a glass of wine afterwards. They really do have their work cut out.
I mean, I imagine it must be not an easy choice to choose one, because that's the job, to choose one. And it is such a high level, and they all play so amazingly. So it's a matter of taste.
Yeah. And well, you hinted a little bit earlier at storytelling and at musicians sort of being themselves, telling us what, giving us a little bit of their personality and their musicianship. Is that what the jury will be looking for, do you think?
I guess on top of a lot of other things, but on this level where everything is in place, the technique and everything, then it is all the tiny, amazing details that are important and that they listen for. And of course, if you can show and project your musicality and tell the story of the music and be lyrical in your phrasing and have that extra energy for like this finale movement of the Bach concerto, then I guess you have a winner.
Not much you're asking for then.
No, a lot, but that's a job, I guess. Yeah. But I think we're ready for the next contestant.
I think we are.
Our final one.
Our final contestant.
Yes. And that is Alberto Navarra. And he is 24 years old and is currently working as a freelance flutist. So very welcome to him and Odense Symphony Orchestra with the conductor Lena-Lisa Wüstendorfer. So, Andrew, we have now dreamt us away in the beginning of the Jolivet concerto. We have danced through the scherzando of the Jolivet, and we have also time stood still, I felt, in the second movement of the Bach concerto. And the finale, it was pure fireworks. I mean, I can't wait till Saturday for the finale, but we need to know the verdict. And the verdict will be announced this evening around 11:30. So you can find the announcement on Facebook or on the webpage of the competition.
You can indeed. So stay tuned for those on those sources if you want to know which of those six flautists from tonight will be proceeding to the finale on Saturday. There's plenty more action from the Carl Nielsen International Competition in the clarinet and violin disciplines, but from the flute discipline until Saturday, when we very much hope you'll join us for the grand final. It's good night from the Odense Symphony Orchestra. It's good night from me and Isabella. And it's good night from this semi-final of the competition. Good night.
Good night.